The topic of my presentation in the EAN 2021 was the safety factor and how it gets reduced in different myasthenic syndromes. The safety factor is a very basic principle of neuromuscular transmission and how electrical information is transferred from the nerve terminal to the muscle fiber, which is crucial to muscle physiology and to muscle contraction. Basically, so upon arrival of a nerve action potential, vesicles, presynaptic vesicles containing acetylcholine are released into the synaptic cleft, and acetylcholine diffuses to the postsynaptic membrane and activates acetylcholine receptors and generates the end plate potential. And the concept of the safety factor now is determined by how much larger the end plate potential is compared to the threshold potential in the muscle fiber that is required for the activation of the voltage-gated sodium channels. The ratio of the end plate potential to the threshold potential required for the generation of voltage-gated sodium channels is termed the safety factor. And this is something ensuring neuromuscular transmission, even in conditions where different factors contribute to an impairment of neuromuscular transmission, such as myasthenic syndromes. Different factors determine the safety factor, among which, for example, the quantal content, which is the sum of presynaptic vesicles released upon each nerve action potential. So the sum of these presynaptic vesicles is one of the major factors determining the safety factor. And other factors also determining the safety factor are the expression level of acetylcholine receptors at the postsynaptic membrane and voltage-gated sodium channels also expressed at the postsynaptic membrane. And lastly, also the extent of the postsynaptic folding is also determining the safety factor. And so any impairment of one of these four factors determining the safety factor can lead to a reduction of the safety factor, which consecutively can determine neuromuscular transmission with all the clinical implications as a result.